Hey, what's up, everybody? It's VR Gamer Dude here, and tonight they expect me to die. And I'm sorry, I'm not gonna let that happen. I don't wanna die. I wanna keep making cool videos for you guys, but apparently Shell Games expects me to die. And so I think we're gonna have to get in there and prove them wrong. So, little backstory. I've actually played this game from start to finish. Now that it's out, I can, you know, tell you fine folks. I was one of the beta testers for this one, and it is absolutely brilliant. From the awesome opening credits all the way to the end game, man, never do you stop thinking in this. Awesome humor. But the entire time I played it the first time, played it with an Xbox controller. So I am really excited to see just how cool it is with hand presence. So let's defy Shell Games and not die. And let's check out I Expect You to Die. All right, folks, and here we are. We're just about to get started. But first and foremost, just wanted to show you, really cool that Shell Games has given you so many options on how you can play this game. So you can actually play it with a mouse. You can play it with the Oculus Touch controllers, which obviously is the preferred way, or you can play it with your Xbox controller. So let's get in there and let's see what it's like to have hands in I Expect You to Die. I love this intro.
I promise you, agent, can't escape me forever. We're playing a game, you take from me, I take from you. But every game ends, and when this one is through, I expect you to die.
The best of the best, you'll die.
I expect you to I expect you to die. When you finally see the worst side of me, we'll finally be eye to eye. I expect you to die. That voice in your ear, they've no chance to save you. A mere puppeteer, they only enslave. You're a piece on a board, I bet with my wealth, my armies and dreams. Your every success unveils still greater schemes. A lake full of acid, a drill from the sky. If you try to fight me, we'll watch your hopes die. Lasers and saw blades with sharks on standby.
Or sharks with lasers.
And this is goodbye. Expect you to die.
The best of the best to die.
I expect you to die. I expect you to die. When you finally see the worst side of me, we'll finally be eye to eye. I expect you to die. I expect you to die. I expect you to die. I expect you to you to die.
Nailed that intro. That was amazing. Oh, love this office.
Welcome to the Enhanced Operative Division. I am your assigned handler and support agent. We're going to be fast friends, I have no doubt. Your new implants allow you to use telekinetic abilities to manipulate the world around you. Back when I was a field agent, we had to pick things up the old-fashioned way, fumbling for it after our third martini. I find testing your spine to be an absolute joy, don't you?
Oh, sure.
Try leaning left.
Okay.
Sometimes our agents need to lean both directions. Try leaning right now.
Gotcha.
Now that we're finished with calisthenics, let's move on to dexterity. Press the button under your index finger.
You mean this button right here?
You found the trigger button. Fully extending that same index finger is what we call pointing. Very useful for pressing buttons. Turn your head to the left.
Okay.
Try pressing one of the buttons on the radio there. It seems you have a grip on those controls.
Uh-huh.
I've left you a very cryptic note by the projector. Try picking it up using the grip or trigger button.
Sure.
Good. Now, I don't normally condone the use of fire indoors, but what the hell? Pick up the lighter on your left and use your left hand to press the Y button, or right hand to press the B button to light it. Use Y or B to burn the note.
Okay, or maybe I could just burn the note.
Excellent. Let's practice aiming with your new telekinetic powers. Push forward on the thumbstick. It's below your thumb.
Out before I, like,
the circle that appears
down
is where you're aiming. If it turns blue, you can pick up the object by using the grip button. Pick up the object we just sent you through the door. Now that you have the target, pull the thumbstick toward you or down to move. You're a natural. While still holding the target with the grip button, let go of the thumbstick and use your thumb to press the A button. That's the... Well done. I wish we could afford real plans, but our dry martini budget is disproportionate to, well, everything else.
Now,
yeah. Try to hover another target over the chair in front of you. Excellent work. Let's try one more, if you're feeling frisky.
Oh, sure.
Hover the third target over the right. Well placed. Now, there's only one thing we do to targets around here.
Well,
shoot 'em. Two, if you count. Great shot. Only... You've passed the test. Now, opening drawers and compartments will be instrumental in navigating the various desks you may encounter on your dangerous missions. Grab the top drawer handle to your right with the grip button. Excellent. I'll unlock the training slide reel from the projector after you retrieve your new mission from the door.
Okay.
To unlock the training slides, grab your first mission from the door.
Well, okay, but let me talk to these folks for a second. So, okay, man, let me tell you, like I said in the intro, I have played this entire game, but I have never actually played it with, you know, motion controls. And it is a great experience on the Xbox controller, don't get me wrong. You can do all the same things. But the hand presence in here is off the freaking charts. I mean, this is amazing. I can't even tell you how awesome this is. I mean, and the frame rates, I mean,
to unlock
everything
the training slide,
is just
grab
really,
your first mission
really
from
smooth
the door
and fluid here. So, all right, let's go ahead and get our mission. And, yep, this one should
well
be
done.
A friendly
Feel
skies.
Free to explore your new office. When you're ready, put in Operation Friendly Skies.
We'll just
do that here mission.
Until we're finished exploring the office here. So, looks like we got some more targets we can hover. We'll go ahead and shoot a few more things here because, you know, shooting guns with a touch controller just feels damn good.
Well done. Feel free to explore your new office. When you're ready, put in Operation Friendly Skies to begin that mission.
Sure. When I'm ready, because I'm going to play with stuff here, because this is absolutely amazing. I mean, I am digging it. So, let's see here. Uh-oh, I'm going to burn the office down. That's what I'm going to do. Fire! Fire! Fire!
Well done. Feel free to explore your new office. When you're ready, put in Operation Friendly Skies to begin that mission.
All right. I'll quit releasing my inner pyro here, and I guess we'll go ahead and get on with it. So, okay, so let's go ahead and take out the training reel here, and we'll go ahead and put in Friendly Skies and see what our first mission is going to be.
We're calling this mission Operation Friendly Skies. I hope you like cars and airplanes.
Oh, yes.
And cars in airplanes.
Ooh, even better.
Dr. Zor, corporate billionaire by day, underhanded villain by night, has a cargo plane scheduled to depart for Zanzibar this very evening. We need you to infiltrate the plane before it takes off, gain access to the vehicle held within, and drive it right off the airplane. Our intel assures us Zor's car is equipped to handle a fall from any height, so we're almost positive you won't die.
Okay, but earlier you expected me to die, and now you're almost certain I won't die. So which one is it there, buddy? Am I gonna die? Am I gonna maybe die? I don't know. I'm getting mixed messages here. So, alright, I guess there's nothing to it but to do it. Nice. Oh, man. This looks so good in the CV-1. I mean, I remember playing the original demo back on the DK-2.
This car can never reach Zanzibar.
It's amazing.
It has some of the most high-tech weaponry in Dr. Zor's considerable arsenal. Naturally, we'd like to poke at it a bit. Drive it off the plane, and you may just earn that vacation you're always going on about.
Sweet. I like vacations, and I like to poke at things, too. Because there's all sorts of buttons to press and things to do in here and levers to move. And I mean, I don't know. You know, this is like my first, you know, I guess the end of my first week with the touch controllers, my first full week. Yeah, I guess I got on like Thursday or Friday of last week. So, man, just absolutely amazing. I still haven't gotten used to this. I mean, that's just great. Whew. That's kind of interesting. One of my hands seems to disappear when I put them both on the wheel. So, alright, let's get on with it here. So, alright, in every level, you're going to find these cards. And basically, these cards are pretty much what you want to do in each level here. And they're going to give us the clues that we need to make everything work. So, okay, so looks like we got a faulty cannon reset system, we've got a bomb at some point in here, and an auto-deploy parachute. So let's go ahead and start opening stuff. Ah, got a little champagne here. I think I'll have me a little drinky before we get started. Take the
edge off a
little bit. A
little early to celebrate, don't you think?
Never too early to celebrate. Can I put the cork back in it? Yes, I can. What do we have here? So we got some smoke bombs. Some cash. Ooh, gun. Oops, hitting my green screen there. Knife. I'll cut you, man. I'll cut you. Alright. And lots of cash. So I'm gonna put all my cash in here. Alright. Go ahead and close that. Oh, more cash. Okay. So, no stogie. So, I mean, you can see there's just like so many things that we can actually manipulate and play with, even in a simple level like this car. So, I love it when a plan comes together.
All right. Smoking may cause a slow and painful death.
Oh, that would be really cool if they actually added the microphone. So if I took a direct, well, maybe they did. No, I think it's timed. So yeah, all right, Shell Games, that would be a really, really nice presence enhancer in here is if, like, you know, you guys use the microphone to listen for my breath, and as if I dragged in real hard, you know, it's like I started dragging on my stogie here. So can I put that out? No. Let's not burn the car down here. Oh. Nah, screw it. It's not my carpet. Okay, so let's see here. What else can we do? Got a key. Start her up here.
Intruder detected. Present eye for retina scan.
Okay.
Scan failed. Targeting.
What? Nuh-uh.
Laser avoided.
Yeah,
deploying
that's
secondary
right.
Secondary countermeasures.
What secondary countermeasures? Oh,
the old ticking
we
bomb.
You got a bomb.
I'm partial to plastic explosives myself, but you must respect the classics. I believe defusing bombs is covered in basic training, yes?
But that was a while ago, and I don't kind of remember how to do it, so let's grab our knife here, because I'm sure I'm going to probably need to cut these wires, and we've got us a handy-dandy chart here. So, all right, so the bomb is armed, and how to arm your bomb. So, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so here's the trick, kids. That's how to arm your bomb. So what we want to do is we want to disarm this bomb. So I guarantee you, we need to do this in the reverse order. So we're going to go 3, 2, 1. All right. There we go. Number 2 is blue. Aha!
No ticking is good ticking, as they say.
That's
now,
right.
Now, can we please focus on getting the car out of the plane?
But I want to
weapons
punch
offline.
Buttons more.
Next message.
Oh. Zor, there is an urgent matter we must discuss. Contact
I never found this during beta
line
testing.
Immediately.
Okay.
Next message.
Hi, I'm looking for Dr. Zor. I'm sure you've been missing your tiger shark spot, and we found them in our girls' high school swimming pool. He's about, 15 feet long, has a freaking laser strapped to his head.
Freaking laser beams on freaking sharks. That's awesome.
So, please give me a call at 412-555-2121 to, pick him up. We'd like to get rid of him as soon as possible. He's already eaten one of our girls, and, I think he might have to pay for that. Bye-bye.
Oh, that's freaking great. So like I said, I beta tested this game, but I never like punched all the buttons because I was trying to be all serious and, you know, trying to figure stuff out. So that was awesome. Nice nod to Dr. Evil. I wonder if Dr. Zor bought the shark with the laser beam from Dr. Evil. So is there any
next
more?
Next message.
We may have an issue with Operation Toxic Rain. I'll keep you posted.
Okay, so I'm thinking there's probably more of those, but I'm not going to spoil it for anybody, so I'm just going to stop pressing that button now and get on with this. Okay, so we have disarmed the bomb. We don't need that. Don't think we need that either. That's just telling us that the parachute's going to auto-deploy. There's nothing in there. Let's see, what do we do with the smoke bomb there? Got some dynamite. Get rid of that. So, okay. So let's see here. Faulty cannon reset system. So it looks like we need to unscrew this panel here. I don't think I'm going to be able to use my knife. And it has been a while since I played this. Now, this was the original demo level as well for the DK2. So I need a screwdriver. Screwdriver's out there. So... oh, hey. That's not good. Roll that window up, dude. There we go. All right. There we go. Aha! Get rid of that panel. And we got us a master reset, which is that switch right there. So looks like we want to reset.
System resetting. Weapons online.
Okay. So that didn't do anything. Oh, that's right. Aha! Oh, Maybe it's not a smoke bomb that we want. There we go. Get that loaded.
System resetting. Weapons online.
Okay.
A bit unconventional, but then again, convention never was your strong suit. You'd better drive the car off the plane before something else explodes.
Do it!
Victory!
Parachutes deployed.
Nice. All right, so 10 minutes.
Another successful mission. Now, about that vacation, I'm afraid I lied about that. But I believe hard work is its own reward, don't you?
Dude, that is not cool. You said I got a vacation after this. I don't know. You're starting to get on my last nerve here.
I see you brought back some explosive souvenirs. Nothing wrong with that, I suppose. Keep it up. We finished dissecting Zor's car, and only two technicians died in the process. A new record. A few of Zor's car phone messages were from the head of a pharmaceutical company that produces lady shampoo. I hope they have plenty on hand, because things are about to get hairy.
Ha-ha.
And dirty. Thus the need for the shampoo. Anyway, your next mission is waiting for you at the door when...
There we go. Okay. So, actually, wait a minute. No, I don't want to replay that.
We're calling this mission...
Okay. Well, I noticed something before I took that out. I was going to actually point out that this has achievements in it, and the speed run was 35 seconds to beat that level. That is insanely fast. I mean, you guys saw it took me 10 minutes. Now, granted, I was fumbling and playing and everything like that. So, all right, shall we do another mission? I think so, because I am really enjoying this game. And this one, ooh, the window washer mission. I love this one.
Zor's people recognize you now, so you'll be going undercover for this mission.
Sweet.
I hope you're not scared of heights. Data retrieved from Zor's car confirms information linked to us from a Dr. Lincoln. We have also heard news that Zor's lieutenant, Daniel Sands, has been researching a supervirus. We need you to infiltrate the lab and destroy that virus.
Okay, I can do that. So... Put on a little more mellow music here. Alright, so... Let's do it. I love this level. So, nice sense of scale here.
We believe Zoraxxus is creating a deadly supervirus. We know Zor wants revenge on the agency, but this is a tad extreme. Get into that lab, and I'll walk you through making an antivirus.
Okay, so let's see here. We got a gun, got some window washing stuff, got a thermos. Oh, got a sandwich. Nice. Okay, neutralize. Neutralize the virus. All right. Let's see, what else do we have here? Okay, so got to get through this window, which I actually... Okay, now, just a little criticism. I shouldn't be able to push my hand through the window. That'd be awesome if you, like, tapped on the glass until you break it here in a second. So, all right, let's go ahead and break the glass. You can't see me. You can't see me. Okay. All right, so let's see here. It's been a while since I played this one, so what am I supposed to do here? Okay. Okay. Attention, Dr. Ashley Lincoln. It has come to our attention that you are engaging in unauthorized antivirus research after hours. Management advocates that there are better uses for personal time, such as spending it at home with your family. It would be a shame if something were to happen to them while you were in the lab working on an unapproved project. Okay. Okay, so let me see here.
Laser tripped.
Not good. It's frickin' laser beams again. Okay. Now can I see the laser beams? Aha! Very cool effect.
We really should ask laser manufacturers to stop selling to obviously insidious individuals.
Yeah. Okay. So, let's see here. Get this through the beams without breaking them.
Laser trip. Oh. Neurotoxin.
Gotcha. Okay, so I think we'll just go ahead and disable.
Please.
There we go.
ID accepted. Security disabled.
Nice.
Full disclosure, Agent, I don't really know how to make an antivirus. However, Sean in HR says you tested well in chemistry, so give it a go. Save millions of lives and don't blow yourself up.
I'm gonna burn all your money. Okay, so let's see here. All right, so we got to get to work on making some chemicals here. Okay, so there's our elements. There's our different types of chemicals we can make. Nope, doesn't look like that's like the one in the intro, so we'll just get rid of that. Alright, get rid of those. Okay.
Stable. Chemical effect negligible. Virus stable. Chemical effect negligible.
Okay, so let's see here. What am I supposed to do? Mommy, RNNNY. Aha, N-N-Y-R-E. There we go. Okay. So that makes some more sense there. Okay. So what am I supposed to do here? Oh, that's right. Okay, sorry guys, it's been a while since I've actually played this. So I think what we need to do is we need to start making some chemicals here. So first thing, let's make something only effective on copper. That's a copper chain. So let's go ahead and make one that's G-I-A-R-Y. So G-I is blue. A-R is green. Go, and Y is orange. Very cool. Aha! Love games like this that make you think. I mean,
Agent,
these are really,
you've been
really
spotted.
Good puzzles.
Quick,
what? Oh.
Act naturally.
Uh-oh. Oh, no. Do-do-do.
All clear. They bought the window washer routine. It seems you have a job if this whole secret agent thing falls through.
I'm a man of many talents, let me tell you. All right, so... there we go. All right, so now we've got all the chemicals here. So, let's see here. So A-R-R-E would make a smoke cloud. I think that was probably what we needed for the laser beams. So probably gonna go ahead and skip on that. So I guess for the purposes of the fact that we are making a video, we should probably speed this up a little bit. So all right, so let's see here. That's gonna make some sort of an explosive, NNGI. What would I need to explode? The bomb? R-E-N-N-Y. So let's go ahead and make the antidote here. R-E-N-N-Y. Okay. Then let's go ahead and make an explosive. N-N and G-I. N-N. Not that one. Not that one. And G-I. I'll have that up there ready. And set that there. And then let's go ahead and make some more of that copper stuff, because it's all coming back to me now. So I know, no fun when you've already played the game, but you know. All right, AR and Y. Okay, so copper explosive antidote. Let's do this thing.
Neutralization attempt blocked. Playing pre-recorded message.
Found a conscience despite our threats. Well, I'm afraid you won't have a chance to use your antivirus. We're changing the timetable and launching the super virus.
Super virus? Well, Hey guys, that's not cool.
Agent, if that rocket launches with an active virus, millions will die. Neutralize that virus now.
Ah. Come on, hurry up. Hurry up. Ah.
Launch imminent.
Did I get it? No. Oh, man. Well, that should have gone in there and blown up, but obviously it didn't, and I have failed and caused a virus outbreak. And I'm sorry, guys. Shell Games expected me to die, and I died. So I think we're going to go ahead and cap it here, getting kind of a long video. There are two other missions in the game that are equally as cool, and I may loop back to this one and do another video to show you the entire game. But man, let me tell you, this is an absolute diamond in the rough. There's a lot of great touch content for launch out there. But this one absolutely takes the cake. So if you haven't played this yet, I am going to highly, highly recommend that you give I Expect You to Die a look. Shell Games, you guys nailed it. But for me tonight, that's going to do it, guys. Thank you so much, as always, for watching to the end of the video. If this was your first time coming in, thank you very much for checking out what I do here on the channel. And if you want to see more great VR content, head over to my main page, take a look through my videos, hit up my sidebar, see what my bros in the VR Spies are doing. And after you've done all that, if you don't mind, see that subscribe button down there? Smash on it. Come along with me the next time I become a secret agent or whatever else the heck I'm going to do in VR. And of course, if this is not your first time coming by the channel and you're already a subscriber, guys, thank you so much for everything that you're doing. The channel's just growing so fast these days, and I owe all of that to each and every one of you. But for me, it's late. I died. Didn't want to die, but I did. Tired. This is VR Gamer Dude. Signing off, y'all. Peace.